Hello, I'm Jeremy Fry. I am the senior pastor here at Advent Lutheran Church. I want to thank you for taking the time to participate in the following worship recording. Our mission here at Advent is to be the followers of Jesus Christ for the sake of the world. For us, that means connecting people to God and connecting people to people. We serve and love our God with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. And then we go out and we serve and love each other with the same love that God has for us. Everyone who walks through the doors of Advent and participates with us needs to know that they are a child of God, wonderfully and beautifully made in God's image. No matter your race, your gender, your sexual orientation or identity, your social economical status, no matter where you come from and who you are loved by God, and you are welcome to come and participate in worship and leadership in any of our ministries. Our ministries happen because of the generosity of our people. If you would like any more information about the ministries here at Advent Lutheran Church, how you would like to get involved, or information on how to give to these ministries, please visit our website, adventbrevard.org. Thank you, and God bless.
Please stand as you are able for the gospel acclamation. The Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing, and the people stood by watching, but the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replies, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Today is Christ the King Sunday, the feast of Christ the King. I have trouble with the word king. It's not good enough. We have and have had throughout history, and even today, earthly kings, earthly royalty. And now the King of Jordan, King Charles, is still around today. The kings of old had power and dominion that today's kings don't really have. But all of that, the word king, does not even come close to the awesome, omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent, omnibenevolent power of Jesus Christ, our King. And they crucified him. In Rome, ancient Rome, crucifixion was something that was reserved for political prisoners enemies of the state, people that were to be made an example out of. As you can imagine, is a horrific, just excruciating way for someone to be executed and on public display. Over Jesus Christ, as he was on the cross, was a sign that says, "Here is the King of the Jews," in mockery, right? Little did they know that Jesus Christ is the King of the entire universe. And as I was preparing for this sermon, the Holy Spirit really brought my attention to the two thieves on either side. You have the one on his right deriding, talking smack. "Are you not the King? Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." And then the other thief, he rebuked him. Rebuked is kind of a funny word. It's a high speech, churchy kind of word. He called him out. As I imagine everyone in this room at one point or another has been called out. Hopefully it hasn't been as strong as a rebuke, but we're all human and we've all been called out. But he rebuked him and said, "Do you not believe in God?" This thief on the left side, he did two things. And the text, the gospel, doesn't really tell us if he knew he was doing these two things. But Jesus, when he was challenged earlier in his ministry, "What are the two greatest commandments?" And he responded with, "Love God with all your heart and soul. And love your neighbor as yourself." So we don't know if this thief had heard of that before, but what he did, he loved his neighbor. You might be asking yourself, as I did at first, like, "God, what? What? He's loving his neighbor." Tough love. He was rebuking him with what he was saying. He was calling him out. It's like, "Shut your mouth, man. Get your weather together. Do you not know that this is God that we are in front of? We are guilty. He is not." And then he had said to Jesus, "Jesus, remember me as you come into your kingdom. Remember me." It's important for us to remember that it wasn't a transaction, that this thief wasn't saying, "Save me. Here, I'm buying my ticket with you, Jesus. Can I go on the ride to heaven?" No, it was a statement of faith. "Remember me as you come into your kingdom." God's grace is not transactional. Candidly, we can't afford it. It is given freely to us as Christ is on the cross. And we also must remember that Jesus was fully human, 100% human, and fully God. And only God can make that math work, right? So he must have been in tremendous physical pain as this is going on. I can imagine. I can't imagine the pain. While he's in this pain, he forgives us. He says, "Forgive them, Father, for they do not know what they are doing." And he also shows his grace to this thief. "Truly, I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." This grace that Jesus Christ, our King of Kings, has given us is freely given, and it is for everyone. Everyone. As my own platoon sergeant used to say, "La-di-da-di, everybody." Everyone in this room. Everyone outside this room. God's grace is for. Now, there are some folks that I'm like, "Nah, no way. God's grace can't be for them." Some folks that in the history of my life, like, But nope, them too. And even as I was at breakfast this past Tuesday, someone said something so incredibly profound, and I want to share it with you. He said, "Throughout human history, there have been some horrible things that have happened. And we attribute this to evil people. We're all grown-ups in this room. We can put some names out there. Hitler, Mussolini, Idi Amin, all of these. And God's grace is also for them. And if I believe, I'll put these words in my mouth, if my concept of God's grace doesn't include them, then my concept of God's grace simply is not big enough. It is not up to me. It is up to the Lord. It's between them and God. Grace is an interesting word too, as we take it and we take into this Thanksgiving week, the giving of thanks, grace, gratis, gracias, thank you. Now the history of Thanksgiving in the United States has something to it, but while we are celebrating and while we are giving thanks for the blessings that God has given us, let us really internalize that, and let's remember that it is His grace that saves us. And I pray and I charge all of us to do that, to have the gratitude on the inside in our hearts, and let that flow out of us. Let Christ, the King's light of His salvation and love, flow freely through us, that we may see and bring His kingdom here to earth. Amen.
God, who gives life to all things and frees us from despair, bless you with truth and peace, and may the Holy Trinity, one God, guide you always in faith, hope, and love. Amen.
Amen.